meet with the family to pay your condolences. What are they saying?
Look, the family is very happy with the presence of MKMVA, because Utata Nelson Mandela was the first commander-in-chief of Mkhonto weSizwe. So to see us in our uniforms here, to come and make our last salute and bid him farewell, the family was very, very happy with the presence of Mkhonto weSizwe here.
Now, is there anything more about the jovial side of Madiba that you can talk to us about? I mean, many people have spoken about it. Anything that you could share with us?
Look, in 1994, when we were in Valmandsdal, during the process of integration, we were treated very bad, to an extent that we marched out of the Valmandsdal to say, we are going to Tata, because he was the first commander-in-chief now of the new army, to say we can't stay under these difficult conditions. The following day, he came to Valmandsdal, and he lashed at the command that was responsible by then, which was the South African Defense Force. When we're happy clapping our hands that he's dealing with them, he then turned and said, I want to come and talk to you now. You are behaving in an ill-disciplined manner. You are raising issues that are correct, but in the manner that you are raising them, you are not raising them correct. Members of Mkhonto weSizwe don't behave in that manner. You must be able to stomach the pain, raise your issues correctly. We are here as your leaders. I'm here as a commander-in-chief to address those issues. Never, never again should you behave in this manner. You are showing people that Mkhonto weSizwe was like an ill-disciplined army.
Is there anything that you'd like people worldwide in South Africa to take back with him, a message or one of the morals that Madiba stood for, anything that you'd like people to remember him by?
You know, Nelson Mandela was a person who volunteered to lead Mkhonto weSizwe, and it was very difficult by then. But when also Mkhonto weSizwe was disbanded and subsequently, before the suspension of the armed struggle, and Mkhonto weSizwe was disbanded, he is the first person to spearhead reconciliation amongst forces that were fighting against each other. We're really confused what type of a leader is one. We went to war, we're still trying to understand each other, but he's in the forefront saying, comrades, you like it or not, we are integrating in this new army. And that is why we have now a South Africa that is non-racial, a South Africa that is united, a South Africa that is non-sexist. Obviously, we are still striving that we must have a prosperous South Africa at the end. That's the leader of Nelson Mandela.
And that was Mkhonto weSizwe's Kebby Maphatsoe, just remembering a committed leader, a leader who fought for the people who led under him, who said they should lead by example, one who spoke of reconciliation all the time. Back to the studio in Johannesburg.
The movement had to gather and regroup in exile and conduct the struggle from foreign and unknown soil. Oliver was already sent abroad to head up the foreign mission of the organization, and it fell on his shoulders to lead the movement in exile.
You're watching a special live broadcast celebrating the life of Nelson Mandela.